Hey guys, welcome back to the Uber Soccer Education Series. Today is going to be a pretty intense and competitive session. We're looking to start off with the usual technical work and then go into some 1v1 exercises to add some competition. We'll be using the Uber Soccer flat markers as well as the different varieties of cones. In order to properly organize my sessions when I'm coaching at the college level, I like to make sure my cones don't get in the way and they can easily be seen to establish boundaries. I've let the players lead their own dynamic stretches so we can get straight into the first exercise. The first exercise is our usual quick thinking and technical warm-up. The player in the box must be shuffling through their feet quickly until the teammate calls out a color. A single step in that direction and then back into the middle. Not only are we warming up the legs, but we're also getting the player thinking early and making sure they're focused. To add some touches, the teammate will call out a color and the player must quickly circle that cone before coming back in the middle and receiving the ball. In a game, recognizing certain cues and being focused can really make the difference between winning the ball or getting there a second too late. We'll incorporate some quick hover exercises in the direction of the color. Once again, when they get back in the middle, the partner can call out a different color. We'll add a bit of dribbling before we get on to the 1v1 competitions. I've set up some cones scattered in the middle with different color spots on the outside. The players have to dribble without touching the cones until their teammate calls out a color. They must immediately dribble in that direction and then around the spot before coming back into the middle. Not only must they quickly change directions and accelerate, but they have to look up to see where they must dribble next. As we move on to the next exercise, I've set up a cone in the middle with a ball on top and some cones on the outside to establish the boundaries. The players will play 1v1 and the objective is to knock the ball off the cone. As the defender, you want to keep a low center of gravity and be patient. You don't want to stab at the ball or the attacker will simply take a touch around you and be in behind. As the attacker, you want to face up, keep the ball close to your feet, and use a bit of creativity to buy you enough space. We'll have the players go until one knocks the ball off the cone. We'll be right back. last exercise is now a 1v1 game where the players must dribble through the cones in order to score a point. We're using the witch's hat cones to create the small goals and the regular cones to mark the boundaries. We've also added a flat marker in the middle. If a player can stop the ball on the flat marker, they get 3 points. In a game, giving up the middle in your defensive third is a very dangerous situation, which can oftentimes lead to a goal. The defender wants to force out wide and away from the goal. The attacker wants to exploit whichever space is open, but if they can manage to get behind centrally, they've done a good job. Try to bait the defender and use those quick changes of speed and direction to get by. So that's it for this one, guys. A quick recap for today. We focused a bit more on 1v1 situations, specifically the defending and attacking roles. We also incorporated the technical aspects like dribbling and first touch. What I like about the cones is that they're a necessary tool for coaches to organize the field and to set boundaries. They're easy to see and can be used in a variety of different ways. Check out the cones and the flat markers we used today over at ubersoccer.com. Until next time, and adios, muchachos. I'm not going to do that.